up gravity filtration as one of the techniques that is used in general chemistry and also in organic chemistry. But for setting up the gravity filtration, we are going to use small iron ring to attach to a ring stand. This is a support for a glass funnel that we are using for our filtration. Now, to prepare the filter paper, I take one large filter paper. I fold the filter paper in half. Fold it in half again for second time. So I fold it in half first. I fold it in half again, second time. Then I open it one part to one side, three parts to the other side. What I don't want to happen, like if someone folds it like this and it's going to make a hole, like the crystals or precipitate is going to pass through. So what you need to do after you fold it twice, one part in one side, three parts in the other side. You've basically made a paper funnel. You place it in the glass funnel. See, it's not staying still. And in order for this to stay still, I'm going to add a few drops of water. When I add some water to the filter paper, the filter paper is going to stay still. Gravity filtration is different from decanting. Decanting, the method for is another technique which we will talk about in different experiments, but here we are doing filtration. So we want to separate the solid from the liquid. We want the solid to go on the filter paper and the liquid would pass through the filter paper. So I'm going to pour the mixture through the filter paper. And because I want to transfer both of them to the filter paper, I can mix it. So to make sure that everything would go, otherwise the solid piece, especially in this case that we have sand for this part of the experiment, it was sand and copper sulfate. The sand is heavy and it's going to stay in the beaker. So we are mixing it, agitate, mix, and then add to the filter paper. Store it well and add. And if you have leftover in the beaker, leftover of solid in the beaker, keep adding the solvent that you were using and pass it through the filter paper to make sure that everything is going to be transferred to filter paper. Now, with this, we have separated the solid from the liquid. The liquid portion now is in the beaker. We have a solution of copper sulfate. It's a blue color solution in the copper in the beaker, and the sand is on the filter paper. Now, if you were going to recover this, measure mass, or the procedure ask for further steps, you can take it out of the filter paper, take the filter paper out of the funnel, place it in a watch glass, let it air dry, then you have dry sand. For this liquid, it can be evaporated and then you end up with the copper sulfate because that's the separation technique or physical means for separation technique.